There we go. Alright, nope. Why is this not working? Again. How are you guys doing this evening? Come on. There we go. Now I can see chat. We're good. I got this. I'm doing pretty good. Not amazing, but pretty good. I need my white paint though. So give me just a second and I will be right back. Here we go. I need white and brown and clear gloss. And I forgot to grab them. Oopsie. Should give me the color I need here. Ooh, it's a little dark. A little too dark. That's gonna be more like my, yellowing on the teeth at this point. I need a much brighter white, but not too bright. Particular. Too particular. A little bit of white. Actually, way more white than that. And maybe just a drop of yellow. Come on. Without getting paint all over my pants. Jeez. Hold the wet paintbrush in your hand, Naomi. Not pay attention to where it's going. I need shaking a little more. Let's don't get any of the right color. Thank you. That's better. Way better. Get the right angle for this. It's gonna take a little bit of water. I just gotta get to the right consistency. My stepmother asked me today, why blood? I thought you were gonna do water. Yeah, that was never my intent. I'm sorry. Blood doesn't drip like that. I'm putting those drip marks on it. Definitely blood. All is well? Dear?
What?
Everything's okay?
Oh yeah, why?
You got lots of taping.
Oh, I was writing Mary.
Oh, okay.
I was sending her a message with the file sheet.
I'm gonna bring this camera up a little bit. Just because I keep almost hitting my head on it, and it's not going very well there. Oh, the poor little guy is biting his own tongue. Poor little creepy tentacle monster. blood. It must be dark and sinister. I don't have bright little flecks of white all over it. I think I can finally get a second coat on the rest of these. Yep. Alright, so I'm gonna just do this over here real quick. Just because it's easier for me to see what I'm doing at this angle. So I could see easier, not that it would be, I could see perfectly. Thank you, though, for the offer. I turned down cheesecake, guys. I swear I made a cheesecake yesterday. Sort of. Because I bought a Publix brand, or a Publix New York style cheesecake. Made a crust for it with ginger snaps. Topped it with black cherries. Canned and preserved, of course, just for the texture, and I wasn't gonna sit there and pit a bunch of cherries really quickly. It wouldn't have ended well. Sprinkled some more graham crackers, or not graham crackers, ginger snaps on top. Called it a day and it was glorious. Alright, I think I'm actually going to use a darker wash. Alright, so the teeth need to dry a little bit before I put the wash on them. So I'm gonna go ahead and start mixing up my purple for the tentacles. I think I'm gonna go with like a bloodstained red. No, maybe red stain. I don't know. I'm trying to figure out my color for these. I might go with the deep red and the deep ocean. Because I want a deep kind of shiny purple, which I think it'll work. And I didn't count how many drops I put in. I should have done that. drops of red. And something like 2 drops of cream color. Make a drop of blue, get it to where I want, back to where I want it. Okay, a drop and a half. Yeah, it's too blue. No, that might not be bad. Because then I can do like a splotchy purple on top of that. So I think on the next one we'll start with 6 drops of blue, 4 drops of red, 2 drops of the cream color and see where we are. And of course once I mix it with the actual brush, it ends up more purple. That's fine. I can do a stronger color for the remainder. I think it's a good base color. Because the rest will be highlighting, shading. Jeez. Hello, Gnome Alone. How are you? Strange and wonderful creature I'm decorating. I wanted to say something Cthulhu-esque. It's gracious amounts of Sculpey. Hot glue for the blood, because why not? It gives it the most glorious, drippy texture, and a vintage or antique, I'm not really 100% sure, teapot that I wasn't able to get clean enough to sell. I don't know if it's just the level of the tarnish or my cleaner wasn't strong enough, but it's perfect for this. So. Because I gave it a real scrub with super strong cleaner. It smells like sulfur. It's disgusting. But I wasn't able to get it clean enough, so it was sacrificed for the greater good. And now I'm actually getting to paint the tentacles while I wait for the teeth to dry. Thank you. And I'm like, do I want to put time enough into another one of these and sell it? Because I think it would be friggin' awesome. I'm very happy with the overall outcome right now. It looks very blue right now. I'm a little iffy about that. And thank you, by the way. I'm generally quite happy with how it's coming out. Yeah, I definitely. I think this is a good base color. It's got, it's a very strong blue, which contrasts really well with the red. And then I can go more purple with my shadows, my highlights, and some of the deeper detail. I do apologize, I'm not particularly talkative at this process, at this step of the process. I should have sculpted this on stream too. You know, as proof that I actually did it. I have the half empty box of Sculpey. After stream, if you go and look at my streams from yesterday, you can see the leech bottle that I did. And my Instagram has a picture of the two bookshelves in the living room that are covered. Oh! Power in your tree. You live in a tree? Or is that just your know me life? Because, I mean, tree houses are pretty awesome. And I hope you don't lose power. That'd suck. This was surprisingly heavy, to be honest. It's like, oh boy. Hey, Prem. How are you? You're terrible. Why are you terrible? We can't all be terrible. I'm doing pretty good. How can I not see that? I can only see it from one specific angle. Which I guess means it doesn't really matter. Okay, I think that's good enough. I can only see that through these tentacles back here, so I think we're good. Thank you, Prim, for the host. As always, I'm very grateful. Very careful not to drop this. I'm so worried that I will and I'll break it. It's pretty sturdy, but I still might freak out. Definitely should have painted parts of this before I assembled the entire thing. Just saying. Have you been up to anything exciting? Prem, I asked you a question. Have you been up to anything exciting? Sayo, how are you doing? I am not whispering. I asked if you've been up to anything exciting. Oh, I'm sorry that you're exhausted, Sayo. That's no fun.
Okay, it needs a little more blue.
Okay, so 8 drops of blue, 2 drops of cream, and 4 drops of red. Yep. Sweet. Awesome. Bless you. What in particular are you looking for? Oh. You okay, baby? Ah. You gonna do more console streaming then? You have a soccer game today, one on Wednesday. You have to miss it because you have dance. And you have a practice on Thursday. So you're gonna shower. Wow. Jeez. Yeah, hopefully they will drop soon for you, Prem. That sounds like quite a busy week, Saya. I'm not sure if she uses the capture card. I don't. Her husband might, though. I thought she was here too, I'm not sure. I can't pull up who's in chat. I don't think. Oh, eek. Okay, go back. Don't do that. It says she's online, but idle. Blood on the teapot yesterday. The plan was to stream from the PS4 and stream Twitch alerts on OBS. We can't multi-stream to Twitch. Aha! Gotcha. Well, it sounds like you have quite a full schedule, Saya. Thank you. That is quite a full schedule. Especially if you're planning on adding more stuff to it. Good heavens. Okay, Prim. You eat really late, let me tell you. Alright, so I'm gonna stop for a second on the blue and go ahead and finish up the teeth. Yeah. I'm trying to remember if you were. I don't think you were in stream yesterday, were you? Or maybe you were. My memory, I can tell you. What was I going to say? Oh, yeah, I might have to be changing my schedule. Yeah, you were in stream. Because you were the last one to say goodnight. I was just saying I'm gonna have to adjust my schedule. I might have not said it though until after you left. Unfortunately, my timing was iffy there. I'm finding that my real life activities. I mean, this is a real life activity too, but my in-person activities, like going places and doing things, is getting in the way of streaming some nights. Especially when I'm out until midnight some nights. is what I got so far.
Hey, Luke. Luke.
I know. I love it.
So we gotta wait for the teeth to dry again, and then I'll apply a gloss coat. I might mix up a little bit more red and do the tongue again, because there's a lovely spot where paint did not adhere to the, where I had to fix it. So I think we're gonna come out with a brighter red on it and make it pretty. But in the meantime, back to the tentacles. Ooh, it would be really cool if I did some tentacles with spikes on the next one. If there's a next one. drops of blue. Four. Two, three, four. Four drops of red. And two drops of fair skin. It's a little bit red. So.
Thank you.
Yeah. That is a great way to come back. Yay! I think you'd gone AFK already. When I was explaining that, my schedule will probably be changing again soon. As unfortunate as it is, real life has been getting in the way of streaming a lot lately. So rather than canceling streams, I'm just gonna change my schedule so that on nights I know I'll be home, I can stream. Yeah, it tends to be. Well, I think this is going to be pretty awesome when it's done. It's just very, very time consuming right now. getting there. Little by little. What did you get to eat?
pieces of beef. Very nice. Sounds delicious. Yeah, did you make it or order in? judge either way.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yeah.
You hear mouse keyboard mouse clicking. Prim wants to know what you're playing. He said nothing right now. What are you doing, research?
You call it that.
Okay, he's doing research. And I will be right back. Thank you. I shall return. Yes, a union break. Start sneezing. I think we can all come to the general agreement that my allergy meds have worn off. Meds over the week? Are you kidding me? My throat gets itchy. I sneeze a bunch. My eyes itch. My nose itches. I have to have these things. The glory that is Zyrtec. We could probably eliminate them pretty good if I just started eating better, but. Because they were doing really well for a long time. I don't know if it's stress or food that's making them worse right now. I know my general inflammation level goes up when I have too many carbs or sugar. But stress will also do it too. I don't know. Thank you. gallon of water a day cleanses the body. Yeah. This is true. I know. I drink a fair amount. Maybe not a full gallon, but a fair amount. Does coffee count? I don't. I know it doesn't. I know. I can joke about it, though. Cracking the whip at me, please. That's meant in a sarcastic manner. Please. Jeez. Well, then I better drink more coffee if it's going extinct. Stuffed monkey coffee bread. An interesting combination that would be. You would have to make a concentrate of coffee. You could do cold brew or something and then reduce it and make it into a syrup and then drizzle that in with your butter and sugar. That would probably be the best manner in which to do that. It's one of those things I could figure out.
have a needle I can open this tip up with. But really, I think that would be the best method in which to do that. Make a reduction syrup. If you're doing a syrup, you can reduce how much sugar you're putting in as is, or maybe use your sugar that's supposed to go into it as your reduction. Or if you're, you know, because you have to make a syrup. And usually in syrups, you add water, or not water, sugar. So rather than making a triply sweet or doubly sweet monkey bread. You could use your sugars and mix it all in, pour it over. Wouldn't be that difficult or expensive to experiment with that. Yay, almost done with the base coats. It's such a tedious process.
happy with how it's coming out. Did you see the picture of the bottles in Discord? I've got to get close-up pictures of everything. And I didn't want to overload any of my social media with pictures today. Otherwise, I would have done, posted everything. I think I just put the link in there.
Hello, Morning Lemon. How are you? Things are very well. Yeah, you can actually see what I'm doing now. I've got the teapot tentacle monster. And I think it's gonna be pretty grand. But I've gotta shine up the teeth. Give them a nice gloss coat. Hey, thank you. I'm glad you're doing well. Are the monster flowers? Oh, awesome. Yeah, I'll show you. Got them right here. Because I haven't taken them any place yet to sell them. Oh, you're talking about the monster ones. Special me. I thought you were talking about the eyeball ones. But these are... These are done. I did a bunch of these. Hey, Speedy. I'm sorry to bother you. Could you grab one of the pots off the kitchen windowsill? So, those are my flowers, and then my husband's going to grab the monster ones for me. So, pretty happy with how these turned out. Yeah, I ended up doing the flowers instead of the wreath. I want to do a wreath later, but it's going to take a lot of eyes because I want to do a big one. So that's kind of on hold while I take care of some of my smaller projects. And if I forget it before Halloween, then I forget it. But I'll get to it at some point because I think it'd be awesome. Alright, I'm just gonna pop this off the plant that it's on, I think. Oh, it's on there pretty good. Oh no, it's not. Uh-oh. I think they turned out pretty good. They go really well with the bright flowers like that. I was a little iffy on them until I put them in the flowers and they were perfect. So overall, pretty happy with how they came out. It's got shiny teeth and everything. There we go. Very happy with them. And this one is on this plant. It's a fake plant. And some crazy little wooden driftwoody pieces, which I'm actually gonna come through and paint, I think. There we go. So I'm probably gonna paint these green or something. The blue makes them stand out, but those for the hair or as a button.
Well, this one is our part of our decor. But the eyeballs are for hair clips.
They're hair clips already, actually.
See? Nice little clippy. I'm going to get these priced up soon. And actually, probably this week. And maybe list a couple on Etsy and throw the rest in a local store that I sell at. So, pretty happy with them. This gloss coat dries clear, so I'm trying to load it on a little bit so it really looks like nice. Ugh, mouth. Oh, okay, good night, Brian. Thanks for coming in tonight. I think that'll be good. I'm going to grab a couple different brushes. I'm gonna try and start working on the texturing now. But I've got to grab a specific brush for it. So give me just a second. See, I told you it didn't take very long. Or wouldn't take very long. I'm trying to say if I want to do shadows now. Or the texturing. I think the texturing would be the best route to go on that. So, I'm going to make a darker version of my, I'll start with the base color. We're going to start with dark version. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 10, 8, 9, 10, we'll go with 12. Come on. Two drops of dark, dark red.
If I can get it to come out properly. Which color is this? Red stone shadow, so it's a nice deep, deep red, almost brown. Okay, now I've got two drops. And then I think three drops of this blue. I'm gonna probably have to watch the stream tomorrow before I do all this and actually make a note. It's a little darker than I had. I'll go a little bit deeper. So we've got 7 drops of that one now. Three drops of this one. Bloodstain red. So 11 drops of deep ocean. 5 drops of deep red, 2 drops of fair skin. I want to say 3 drops of redstone, 2 drops of bloodstain, and 7 drops of soft blue. Gracious amounts of water. That will thin the paint down enough to be a wash rather than straight up paint that you have to blend. Of course, I got mixed up with what I was going to try and do, and I did my shadow before I did my texturing. But that's okay. I'll work. What is the dripping blood made out of?
Hot glue. It's hot glue that's been painted a deep red mixed with this. It's a clear red. This is the clear red just by itself. Oops. Right here. That's dried. It's got a nice, trying to show you. It's got a nice clear shade to it, but dries really nicely as a blood. And mixed with the deep red like that, it goes more opaque. I'm probably gonna have to go through and touch up some of it. I like doing the shading. It doesn't technically need it. If you want to get down to it, the light will shade it and highlight it as needed, but it gives it a much better appearance if you do it. Makes it look much more finished. Sorry, I know I'm holding this out of your view at the moment, but I have to be able to change the lighting so I can see where it needs shaded. Once I have my base shading down, I will come back through and go over it. Make it darker where it needs to be darker and lighter where it, or leave it where it should not be too dark. I like to build it up in glazes based on, you know, how it needs to be. Just gives it a better look. I'm also using my finger a little to smudge it in where I can't get it to do it with the brush. Helps make it smoother. It's amazing how much you can carry over from painting miniatures, just on a much larger scale. Oh yeah, I really like how the teeth dried. Nice and glossy. Very happy with that. wanted to go a little bit darker on this. Just a few drops. Will you put glaze or protective coat on the arms? Probably. Though I may incorporate the glossy part into the texturing rather than actually doing it gloss. And I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to do it. Just because I don't want the whole thing to be glossy. We'll see. It's gonna be a matter of what method I can use to put it on, because I've had problems with my gloss coat smudging stuff. I'm afraid that my matte one will do the same thing, because they're by the same company, same base and everything. They're just different finishes. And if I do a matte coat across the whole thing, it's going to mess up my glossy blood and everything. So, I think if I do any kind of a gloss finish, it will be just the texture and some of that. They're pretty. They don't need a whole lot of protective finishing to it. It's sculpy, so it's pretty sturdy. It's not going to be exposed to the elements. In fact, this is a piece that I will keep inside instead of letting it go into the storage shed. because that would probably mess it up. Just where the hot glue is, you know, heat sensitive. Our temperatures are starting to cool off, but a friend of ours did a temporary fix on a sign that they have outside their house, and they use hot glue. Which is fine and dandy. But in the summer, the Florida heat, as it were, the hot glue melted and the sign fell apart. They've since, you know, fixed it more permanently. But it was very surprising that just the sun heated it enough to melt it. Yeah, I need to go darker with my shadow. You can see it, but I don't think it's dark enough. Alright, what did we have here? We had 11 drops of this. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Four drops of this one. Two, three, four. Three drops of that one. Okay, accidentally four. We're gonna drop this back to one drop. And then I think we had four drops of this one. And two drops of this one. Except I think that's the same red that I used already. And hopefully that'll give me a close enough color. Yeah. I think I'm gonna add one more drop of this dark blue. I'll go with two. Okay. Just needs to have that more blue tint to it. And my water. And let's see how this goes. It's not really that much darker. It looks darker when it's wet. Apologize for the location shift again. I'll try and work quickly right here. I think that is dark enough to be a make a difference. Thank you.
Oh, it's not points anymore. It's, hang on. It's random, or it's, yeah, it's random bucks. But you just have to type bucks. Changed a while back. Darn, I got red all over the teeth when I did the gloss. I didn't see it in the lighting that I had it in. I might have to redo them. Top of my head. I could probably do it pretty cheap, but see, if I did it first class, it probably wouldn't be more than about $6 because they're very lightweight, but I cannot guarantee that. If you want to private message me your zip code or your, you know, even your address, I promise I'm gonna. Sometimes it's calculated on. See, I think I could set that up on that shop. You have to have the payment system set up a certain way to be able to use the calculated shipping. And I don't know if I have it set up that way on that shop. So yes, it can be calculated on Etsy. Okay, cool. No worries. Try and get them listed this week. Because I need to get them out of here. I'm taking up space. And it's getting close to Halloween. If a Canadian like you wants to order and get them in time for Halloween, you gotta order soon. I saw that there was supposed to be another postal strike for you guys. Did that fall through? I hope it did. They need to get their little issues all worked out so it doesn't affect people selling. Awesome. All the
business and you're like, no, don't do this to us. We have to use the postal system. Well, I think this is where I'm going to have to stop for tonight, just because it's getting late. It's after 1 now. I've got a pretty good start on my shading. I'm going to do a little bit more, so I'm actually going to see if I can save this. Hey, baby. Would you mind getting me a little round bowl from the kitchen cabinet? I need to save this wash that I made. Before it dries up. Tomorrow I'll finish shading, I'll do texturing. And maybe play with some gloss on it. I'm probably gonna fix these teeth. They got a lot of red on them, and I'm not so happy with that because it's not the right shade of red to be blood. So. Did you find it, babe? Awesome, thank you. Thank you, sweetie. That's not very much, but at least be enough to go over some more of it. It looked like more than it was, to be honest. It's like, jeez. Okay. Well, this is a good point for me to wrap it up tonight. Tuesday night stream should be a go for 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I can hopefully finish this guy up and be good to go and move on to my next projects. So thank you guys for watching. And if you are watching and want to see how this progresses and you have not followed, then go ahead and follow and come back tomorrow and see how this guy turns out. Obviously. Good night.